Hello, friends. My name is Reverend Doug Neufeld here at Trinity United Brandon, and I just want to thank all of you for joining us for our Remembrance Day Sunday service here, this 23rd Sunday after Pentecost, our 35th Sunday of the pandemic, and this service that will be available for November 8th. Just want to give some feedback on potential reopening. I know this is a subject that we've been talking about lately. Pretty obvious with the direction that the province has gone, Winnipeg deeply into red, and the rest of the province in orange. Although Brandon itself is, you know, fairly safe, you know, we just don't want to take any risks at this time. So we'll continue to monitor. We're excited about taking an opportunity to regather, but we just feel this is best for everyone to keep everyone safe, and we'll continue to worship in this virtual manner. Thank you so much for being patient, and we hope to see you soon. I just want to take this time to thank those that are helping produce this, such as Ken and Carol Winston that are always here every week helping put this online. Holly's back with us this week, and we're so blessed to receive her musical gifts. And we have Barb and Shirley that are going to do the placing of the wreath at that point of our Remembrance Day service. So as we move into our time of worship, I just ask you to take a moment to just calm your minds and open your hearts to the Word of God. Please join me in the call to worship. On this Remembrance Sunday, we gather to pray for a world where no one will learn war anymore. On this day when the guns once fell silent, we gather to pray for peace to reign in every heart, home, and nation. On this day of hope, we come before you, God, to remember all those who gave their lives so we could be free. In this time of story, song, and prayer, help us to catch a vision of how the world could live together. And so let echo the old prayers, make us channels of your peace. In that spirit, let us join our hearts in song. Please join me in the singing of our first hymn, Make Me a Channel of Your Peace, from Voices United 684. Join me in the singing of this hymn.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your healing power. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. O Spirit, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console. To be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Let me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Spirit, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console. To be understood as to understand. To be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. In giving to we're born to eternal life.
Let us pray. Almighty God, grant that we who gather here today may pay fitting tribute and honor to the memory of those who have died in the service of their country. May we be so inspired by the spirit of their love and courage that, forgetting all selfish and unworthy motives, we may live only to your glory and to the service of your people. May we who desire peace be willing to work through justice. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As we go into the portion of the service of remembrance, please join me in the singing of our national anthem. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. Thank you. Eternal rest grant unto them, O God, and may perpetual light shine upon them. May the souls of the righteous, through your great mercy, rest in peace. Amen.
The reading for today is from Matthew 25, verses 1 to 13, the parable of the 10 bridesmaids. Then the kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, and 5 were wise. When the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them, but the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, all of them became drowsy and slept. But at midnight, there was a shout. Look, here is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him. Then all those bridesmaids got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish said to the wise, give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out. But the wise replied, no, there will not be enough for you and for us. You had better go to the dealers and buy some for yourselves. And while they went to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went with him into the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later, the other bridesmaids came also, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he replied, truly, I tell you, I do not know you. Keep awake, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour. The word of our Lord. Thanks be to God.
As I reflect back on my earliest experiences of Remembrance Day, it probably takes me back to primary school, or maybe as early as kindergarten. We would get past that point of harvest and Thanksgiving. I remember doing art and coloring, and there would always be pictures of turkeys or those horn things full of vegetables and fruits, you know, signifying the harvest. And then from there we would go into Halloween, which was always so much fun, and costumes and Halloween parties. And once we had come down from that sugar rush, we would start to get projects from our teachers for Remembrance Day. And I remember having, you know, big white crosses where we would use up our red crayons coloring and cutting and creating these poppies that we would stick to it. We also in those times start experiencing like a school assembly where they would bring in representatives from the Legion, and we would have a children's version of remembrance, and we're first introduced to the concept of remembering, being thankful for those who lost their lives in wars to secure our freedoms. We got that message, you know, pretty early. Now, my experience of Remembrance Day started to evolve, especially around grade 9. And the reason why I said that is that I was in band in school. In fact, I was in the the senior high school band by grade 9, and being part of the senior concert band automatically put you in the Legion's Remembrance Day service every year. And so we'd have to dress up in our band uniforms, and we were very fortunate that we had these very fancy, they were like polyester tuxedos with these white overlays. And for marching band, we had these big, tall, furry hats and everything. We didn't have to wear the hats for Remembrance Day, but you know, these suits, you know, for kids that are used to jeans and t-shirts, we weren't ever really excited about having our band uniforms on. And so here it is, a holiday, and whereas some of the kids would be off doing whatever they were doing, I mean, I know myself, I would have rather been on my dirt bike or snowmobiling, and we know from mid-November that it could be either, or anything in between. And we were a captive audience, because, you know, we had to play O Canada, God Save the Queen, probably another piece, and our first trumpet player would always do the bugle part of Last Post. And so, as this captive audience, I started to see a different dimension. You see, there was always that part in the service, you know, like Shirley and Barb did, where they brought up the wreaths and placed them at the front. And, you know, as the town of Boisevain service, you would have various dignitaries bring up wreaths, you know, like the mayor and so on and so forth. But I started to notice a real difference between any of the vets that were bringing forward wreaths. I started to sort of notice something different about them. They weren't exactly stoic or sad, but there was something in their eyes, something that only now that I guess was the pain of the experience, the pain associated with remembering. The face of a person who had been tortured for decades with these traumatic memories. Remembering for them was a very different thing than the remembering that we were being taught to do. You know, back then, there was no concept of PTSD. We heard stories from relatives of war veterans that the war changed them. And we would often hear from their children or grandchildren that when they asked about their relatives' war experience, they didn't want to talk about it. But back then, the imagery of Remembrance Day was all about the fallen. Fields of poppies and cemeteries of rows of white crosses. And we embraced the families who lost loved ones in those conflicts, consoling them in their sacrifice. Back then, we celebrated those heroes that came home victorious. And we were somewhat oblivious that they too were victims in the war. It wasn't until much later that we started to realize the whole damage done to those who returned. We always saw the effects of those who were wounded, the missing limbs, physical scars, the limps, or even the purple hearts that were amongst the assortment of the medals on their chests. We now started to see the other damage inflicted on those who survived those traumatic events. We started to see how families struggled when their loved ones came home broken. Now, the parable of the 10 bridesmaids can be problematic in interpreting what Matthew is trying to say through his telling of Jesus' message to his disciples. The most common is the analogy of the second coming, placing Jesus as the bridegroom and the people as the bridesmaids. Unfortunately, it gets a little challenging when you try to consider who might be the bride at the banquet. For the purposes of this Remembrance Sunday, it's easy to see the message of remembering. Remembering the lessons of experience past. Being prepared for what may come. Even if we don't know exactly when it may happen. The parable also demonstrates the consequences of not being prepared, of not remembering. For Remembrance Day, we are called together to first remember those and their families who gave great sacrifice to the liberties and of those of us in this country, and so many others in this world. Remembrance Day is also a time to remind us of the terrible consequences of armed conflict, especially to our politicians and world leaders. Sometimes it is the right thing to do. Sometimes it's absolutely necessary to put the people of our armed forces into harm's way. What we can't do is let our leaders forget the cost of these decisions and let them make these decisions lightly. For all those affected by armed conflict, we will remember them. Amen. Please join me now in the singing of our next hymn, For the Healing of the Nations, from Voices United 678. Please join me in the singing of that hymn. Let us pray. God of each life and all lives, in every generation you have been present with your people. In times of poverty and prosperity, in times of sorrow and joy, in times of health and pandemic, in times of war and peace. Today we remember your gracious care in times of crisis and give thanks for the courage and sacrifice of the members and families of the Canadian Armed Forces who have worked for peace, justice, and protection in so many different times and places. Support those who have finished their time of service and still face the challenges in civilian life. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of promise and peace, we thank you for the places where conflicts have ended. Peace has been restored, and where citizens can enjoy secure freedoms and human rights, where people are oppressed and dissent restricted, encourage those who witness and work for justice to be established. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God of wholeness and hope, we thank you for those called to serve others in their home communities, wherever they call home. Especially we give thanks for those in our communities working hard in the face of COVID-19. May they know your protection and show your love in all they do. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of commitment and courage, we thank you for the many organizations in Canada working to bring hope to people facing social exclusion, discrimination, or exploitation. Inspire leaders in our communities to provide access to the support they need to thrive. May all your beloved children enjoy the life you desire for them. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God of Christ and community, we thank you for the dedication of those who serve in the church. May your church always be a place of hope, healing, and welcome. Guide our congregation and denomination through these challenging days so that those who turn to us will find us faithful. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Eternal God, your promises endure from generation to generation. And knowing your steadfast love, we trust you to answer our prayers according to your generous mercy and infinite wisdom. And now, with gratitude for your love poured into the world through Christ Jesus, knowing that you are our mother and our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Once again, I want to thank all those who have been involved in the running of the church through this time, the support peoples, although, you know, not much is going in the church publicly, there's still so much work that keeps it running. And so we need to remember those who dedicate their time so unselfishly. I want to thank everyone who continues to support the church through your givings. We appreciate so much that although you haven't been able to attend in person, you haven't forgotten us, that you continue to tithe your treasure with us and share from your abundance. That helps keep this ministry alive. and for this we thank God for you. Go forth this day and keep your lamps lit. We go with hearts ablaze with God's love. We go forth this day and shine with God's light. We go with lives kindled with the call to serve. Go forth this day and enter into fullness of life. We go to embrace the life we received. Amen.